Hi, my name is Matthew. I'm a cybersecurity analyst at CQURE, and I will go through introduction to stackwalking. So, in order to enable call stacks in XPerf, you need to choose what type of event you want to call stacks for. Make sure that event is being recorded, and then enable call stacks for that type of event. The sampling profile events from the kernel provider are one of the main uses of call stacks. The profile events can be enabled with the profile kernel flag, or by using some of the kernel groups such as base or latency, which include the profile flag. For a list of all the kernel flags and kernel groups, we are using xperf minus providers k. And here you can see the whole list of kernel flags and kernel groups. So, in addition to enabling the sampler provider, we need to enable stackwalking on that event with the minus stackwalk command. We also need to make sure that the proc underscore thread and loader kernel flags are enabled so that the XPerf tools can identify what modules the code addresses are in. Putting this all together, we are left with the command xperf on proc underscore thread plus loader plus profile minus stack walk profile. And after a moment, we can stop xperf by using the following command: xperf minus d my trace dot ETL. As you can see, we have got merge ETL, mytrace ETL, so it has been captured. You can alternatively use the kernel group latency because it also includes the proc thread and loader kernel flags. We can use xperf minus on latency minus stack walk profile, and it will work the same way. Let's stop it once again with the same command. Okay, so many events can have stack walking enabled using this basic method, so that if you want to call stacks for context switches or registry operations, you can get them. For a complete list of events that can have call stacks enabled for them, use xperf minus help stackwalk. And here you've got the complete list of kernel logs provider. You can also record call stacks for manifest-based ETW events, but the syntax is quite different and it only works on Windows 7 or above. When you specify your ETW provider to xperf after minus on, you can specify extra parameters after the provider name separated by colons. The syntax I will show you is used with the latency set of kernel flags, enables stackwalking on the profile events, and starts a user session called browse. It also enables the Microsoft minus IE ETW provider for that session with call stacks recorded for all of those events. Let me paste the command here, and here you've got the whole command. xperf minus on minus stackwalk profile minus start browse minus on Microsoft slash IE, and here we've got stack in the colons. We can leave the flags here and here blank and just specify the stack. Let's run it. And after a moment, we can stop it by using xperf minus stop, browse minus stop minus d my trace.etl. As you can see, it stopped tracing it. We can now open it, open the file mytrace.etl with WPA, which stands for Windows Performance Analyzer, mytrace.etl. And we are getting a graph of everything that has happened. You can expand those categories. I'll expand computation maybe, and I will use CPU usage. Click on it, and after right clicking, you can add graph to analysis view. And here you've got the detailed analysis, for example, for the CPU usage here. So XPerf, the Windows Performance Analyzer, summarizes multiple stack walks together, collapsing them down when they are identical. And in the count field here, you can view how many stacks were collapsed together on each row. The wait command shows an estimate of how many milliseconds of CPU time were spent in that call stack. And the percentage wait column shows that as a percentage of total CPU time available.